Hello, everyone. It is right now, Tuesday, December 31st, in the year of our Lord 2013, as we prep ourselves and get ready for the 2014 extravaganza. It's the New Year's Day special edition of Beer and Sign of Day. What is that? Delilah. She's such a princess. Well, hello, everyone. How are you doing out there? I am doing awesome as always. Wicked awesome. And folks, today's unofficial sponsor of our show to start the new year off right is Lobo, leader of the pack. Good beer. Pedernales Brewing Company. My man Lee Hereford. He runs a phenomenal business. Great guy. Met him in person. Fredericksburg down there in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma. Phenomenal place. Phenomenal beer. And you need to get yourself some.
I nearly fell asleep.
And folks, as I prepare myself for something special, let's have the last shot of 2013 of Captain Morgan's private stock. As we're getting ready to watch the ball drop.
Drinking any of that.
No, you're not. Cheers to Captain Morgan and all of you processes saying Germany Kapai as they say in Japan. Good stuff. Aha.
They're just like singing a song.
Well, they screwed up. I thought they were going to show. I guess we're not going to get to watch the ball drop on TV. We got 1 minute, folks. 1 minute. By golly. So what I'm going to do is, folks, today's beer of the day, as we bring out the bell ringer. The ringer indeed it is. And folks, oh, I know what happened.
Wrong channel?
Yep. No, it's not. Yeah. Well, folks, guess what? By golly, it just hit midnight down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Southern Oklahoma. And would you look at that? Already got myself our man, Big McLodge Huge, Justin Dimmitt, sent a message.
Happy New Year from Okinawa.
Okinawa, Japan, folks. Thanks there, Big McLodge Huge. And Happy New Year to us. It is 2014, right, Delilah?
Yep, happy 2014.
Aw, yeah. All right, folks. Well, let's get ready to celebrate. We got it right here, right now. Here you go. Celebration 1980. Cool in the gang. And by God, out with 2013. And on with little 2014, baby. Happy New Year. Yeah. Can't be too loud, because we'll wake mommy up like we did last year. Remember that? Alright, folks. It is time to bring out the homebrew that I love so much. Thank you, Big Dave Bauer, for introducing me to your friend, a great man indeed, my friend now, Tom Barkley, down here in Yeehaw, Texas, otherwise known as Western Louisiana. Folks, this is Hair of the Dog Homebrewery. He's a multiple gold medal winner, award-winning brewmaster. Hair's Dog Homebrewery, Scotch Wee Heavy. Born November 11, 2013, and bottled November 24, 2013. Dave Bauer and I were there. We helped put it all together, all the ingredients and everything, folks. And, folks, I'm excited. This has approximately 8.5% alcohol by volume. Proper barrel opening apparatus, proper technique. Here we go. $45,000, right in the big Simpson apparatus, right on the keyboard. But I'm just that damn good. Haven't spilled a drop yet? Never have, never will.
Anybody have that?
There you go, Delilah Beans. This is going to be a challenge here. This is, this mouth is not, these are very cheap. I want better sunglasses. They didn't have any. Cheer the bears all, you pros, they say in Germany, goodbye as they say in Japan, and happy 2014, baby. This is truly Méchant Junior, which is French for wicked, awesome, A-plus all the way, Tom Bikley. This is an award-winning beer right here, man. This is Nectar of the Gods. This is awesome. Wow. More like hair of the beard getting in hair of the dog, huh? Well, folks, wow, we got a lot of birthdays to get to. And, Delilah, I need you to do me a favor. I did. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention it. Hey, do me a favor, run downstairs and get the iPod that I brought downstairs accidentally. Whoops. Folks, we got a lot of birthdays to get to, okay? I'm wicked tired. I already recorded a show earlier. There's a lot of this day in history to get to. I got the hiccups. Wow, 2014 starting off a little rough. I am not drunk. I'm not even buzzing yet. I will be by the end of this show, though. Happy birthday to Lucky Windsor. Lucky Windsor Dimmitt. The famous two-time fan of the week. Those dogs are incredible. Lucky Windsor Dimmitt, happy birthday to you. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Living in Okinawa, Japan. A wonderful place. Wonderful dogs. And Lucky Windsor, hope you have a wicked awesome day. Party hard and enjoy. Celebrate like it's 1969, minus the acid. Have a howling good time. Cheers and beers to you. Ugh, I know, fake beard. Get it? Ah, and I paid $2 for this and another $2 for this. Walmart special, folks. What do you want from me? But anyway, next on the list, my man, Eric Alisasis. Now, this guy is a cop I know from jolly old England, living in Guam. He's a Guam guy, and he's celebrating a milestone birthday today. No, he's not. Yeah, he is. Now.
I can't find it.
Oh, great.
Where is it?
I don't know. I lost it. I lost the iPod. That's great. Delilah?
Yeah?
Give me a moment. Ali, happy birthday to you, brother. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. And hope you party hard and enjoy. Great man. He's so awesome that we hung out in Bible camp together 2.5 years ago. We found God, learned lots of scripture. And Ali, I know you're a beer pong legend. You and Matt St. Andre. Hey, cheers and beers to you, brother. Happy New Year's. Happy birthday. Party hard and enjoy. And yummy. I got a lot of hair in my mouth. Delilah, you need to take over the camera for a moment because Daddy has to go get that.
Hi. Really fun. You stand up. Happy New Year. Woo! I don't even know. My hair is blue. I really don't know what's on TV. What are they trying to... Oh. Are you serious? I mean, it's just some dude going to work.
What happened? Did you say hi to anybody?
Hello!
You just sat there and looked pretty? Is that what you did?
And said a couple things.
Oh, okay.
You'll figure out when you upload the show.
Ah, nice. Well, folks, let's get through them birthdays. We got the iPod. It's charged up now. It was dead. I had to recharge it, and I forgot it was on the charger. Next birthday goes to my man, Paul Lowry. An awesome man. A legendary man. And a man of the mafia wars. Oh, look at this. Text messages galore. What the hell? I don't even know what that said. Happy New Year's from my man, Seth Drake. Seth, thank you, brother. Happy New Year's to you, too. So, this is not going to be a normal show. Huge dinner tonight, by the way. So I'm still stuffed. Whew. Alright, well, happy birthday, my man Paul Lowry. Hope you're doing well. Hope life's treating you absolutely wicked awesome. Mafia Wars legend. Great man. Ah. He's not, no. I'm confusing him with somebody else, by golly. He's a badass legend of a man I work with down here in Yeehaw, Texas. Otherwise known as, that's right, Northern Mexico, of course. And Paul Lowry, a great man indeed that I work with down here. Legend of a man, BMF, bad mofo. And a wicked hardcore New Orleans Saints fan to boot. For he is a Louisiana man. And now, Paul, my friend, celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers to you. Next on the list, my man, Jung-Hoon Pak. Now, here's a fine outstanding graduate of Martha's Vineyard Beach High School class of 1993, living in New York. Great man indeed. And, Jung-Hoon, I'm sure I'm going to hear from you today as I post up on your birthday. Because I hear from you every now and then. We talk a lot. Great times, a great man, no question about it. Jung-Hoon, hope you have a wicked awesome day, brother. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers to you. Shutting this crap off. All right, next on the list, we got Melanie McDade, a wonderful lady, very good friend of my beloved love goddess, Farrah. We know her from jolly old England. Mel, happy birthday to you. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Happy New Year. Happy birthday. Always a pleasure hearing from you. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers. Next on the list, there's a lot of birthdays. John Hammer. Now, this is a Mafia Wars guy that I added not too long ago on the old Facebook. And John, happy birthday to you, brother. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Don't take your name and go getting hammered now. Ha ha! John Hammer, you say the hammer for the Mafia Wars, man. It's all about whacking schmucks and schmuckettes, my friend. And brother, you have a wicked awesome day. Cheers and beers to you, bud. Hope you enjoy the show. I'll be lucky if this thing lasts to 2015, man. Ugh. These things don't sit very well, you know. Holly Brigere. I knew her as Holly Carroll. Holly, happy milestone birthday to you. How you doing? Hope you're doing well. She's a fine outstanding graduate of Martha's Vineyard Beach High School class of 1993. And Holly, wonderful lady, Vineyard Haven girl, known her over 30 years. And Holly, you haven't aged a bit. What's the secret, huh? Well, hope you have a phenomenal day. I never forgot your birthday. I mean, especially yours. I mean, come on. New Year's Day. That's easy to remember. And a milestone birthday this year. That is absolutely wicked awesome. Squeeze me. So cheers and beers and celebrate well and enjoy. Scotch wee heavy. Definitely. Trying to keep it quiet. Definitely a bell ringer. My man Max Hawk, another Mafia Wars guy, a BMF, bad mofo. Max, what's going on, man? How you doing? Hope you're doing well. Hope you enjoy this crazy show. Hope you have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Cheers and beers to you. And then we got Dale Chalupka. This legend of a man was born the same exact month, day and year as my good friend Holly Breguer. Dale, what's going on, bud? How you doing? Haven't heard from you in a while. Badass coot dog. I know from exotic Japan, a great country indeed. And Dale, hope life's treating you good. Life's treating me wicked good. It's been absolutely freaking awesome. And brother, hope you have a phenomenal birthday and a happy new year. Cheers and beers to you. And then John Lemon, the final birthday today, another Mafia Wars man. John Lemon ain't no joke. He's a badass mofo. Great guy. Always helped me out on the Mafia Wars. Hey, it's all about good people helping good people. Don't reach out to other good people as we whack schmucks and schmuckettes out there, you know? Lots of fun. Great way to get rid of pent-up frustration. You get home from work, get on the Mafia Wars, and whack a few fools. All in good fun. And it's not really whacking them. Come on now, what do you think we are? Some kind of violent people? Hell no! John, happy birthday. Have a wicked awesome day. Celebrate well and enjoy. Alright. We hooked up the birthdays, double checking the list, making a list, checking it twice just to make sure I didn't miss anyone. So we got a trivia question, folks, and then we're going to hit it up because we got a lot of babes and hunks for you. Lots of this day in history. I mean, a lot of things happened on New Year's, folks. It's an epic show, and I'm going to have a whole lot of music coming for you. Five of my favorite songs that I think are great party tunes. Based on different genres of music that I love so much. What date did the inaugural Times Square ball drop start, and what year did it bring us to? Well, my good friend Jennifer Leone, hey, another Mafia Wars person. I have yet to meet this lady in person, but I talk to her all the time. She's a wicked hardcore Dallas Cowboys fan, and I know she's not happy about what happened this Sunday. But, you know what? You still got a lot of rings, Jennifer, so don't be upset. We play the Facebook apps a lot. We play Mafia Wars together. Lots of fun. And we love Song Pop. Oh, yes, we do. Song Pop, Movie Pop, lots of fun. And Jennifer Leone, you said 1907, 1908, because December 31st, 1907, the ball drop started Times Square, as they like to say in New York. Times Square. All right. I'm from Massachusetts. We don't say square. We say square. Okay? It's close. But anyway, December 31st, 1907, it started to bring in January 1st, 1908. January 1st, 1908. New Year's Day, 1908 was the first year the Times ball drop was brought into for the year that it brought us. I'm rambling on now. Jeez, I'm tired. Hey, I've been awake for 17 hours after a 4-hour sleep. What do you want from me? Anyway, Jennifer Leone, you are 100% absolutely correct. Wicked awesome job. Big love, Dr. Salute, to you. The first correctly answered trivia question for 2014, although she answered it in 2013. Anyway, I will drink to that. Hail to the effing yeah. I think my daughter's tired. Hey, she's 11 and she stayed up, so proud of her. Love Goddess didn't hang. But I didn't wake her up this year, so that's kind of cool. Last year, remember, she woke up and came in here and yelled at us? Oh, boy. So anyway, We got a lot of celebrity birthdays. Folks, let's get to our first babe of the day. This is babe of the day number 598 on Beer and Song of the Day. And oh, is she gorgeous. And for a gorgeous babe, we're going to bring out a phenomenal song. How about one of my all-time favorites ever? This is what real rhythm and blues is all about. Mamo Mamo, June 10th, 1955. Marvin and Johnny, the best damn duo ever. I know, a lot of people say the Righteous Brothers. Hey, they were pretty badass too, I'll give them that. Squeeze me. Marvin and Johnny, both still alive. One's 85, the other's 82. And Mamo Mamo, a real rock over song for a real rockin' hottie. Journey Smollett. Journey Smollett. Is she hot or what? She's hot to talk. Ooh, baby. This is one fine ass low man. Yeehaw. Ooh, no. Hello. She's another Mary Jo and satisfied my soul. Hey, Mama! Mama, Mama, Mama! Mama, Mama, Mama! Damn, it's already been 21 minutes and 48 seconds. Yowza. Oh, is she hot or what? Sexual chocolate! Sexual chocolate! Woo! That'll make you blow your horn, won't it? Damn right, Raven, that's me. Gotta have a great instrumental break. There we go. Hello, honey. Ain't that a lovely smile, huh? You damn right it is. That's it for our lovely Journey Smollett. If that woman ain't wicked hot, I don't know what is. Oh, bless me. Thank you. New Year's and I gotta blow my nose on the show. How about that, huh? Still got that cold going on. Cold's been going on so long, it's been going on for 2 years. 2013-2014. Gross. Yuck. Uh-oh. What the hell was that I heard out there? Oh, boy, I'm all falling apart now. Bad. Well, I wouldn't want to have boogers running all over my face. That'd be kind of gross. I know, I get it. If it doesn't get all over the place, it doesn't belong in your face. I see. Good old Justin Dimmitt with a thumbs up. Yeehaw! All righty. Well, folks, we're going to bring out our hunk of the day in just a moment. Let's knock out a few celebrity birthdays. How about Sarah Wayne Callies? C-A-L-L-I-E-S. She's 37, definitely a gift sent from heaven. And she is on The Walking Dead. Boy, is she hot. Betsy Ross, born this day in 1752, passed away at the age of 84 in 1836. That's right. Designed the American flag that we know and we love so much. America! Hell yeah. Yeehaw. Mini-Me. Vern Troyer. 45 years old today. That little fella. Oh, not the most handsome fella in the world, but by golly, Mini-Me, who was definitely catchy. And, freaking, Drawing a blank. Michael Myers. Austin Powers. Thank you. Ugh. These hairs fall out quickly. Ugh. Yeah, it looks like 2014's a little rough this year. Start shitty, finish strong, we hope, right? That's what I'm hoping for. Hey! There's only 364 more days till, 365 more days until 2015, you know. Not a leap year this year. Alright, let's get to our hunk of the day, number 499. We're gonna bring out another rockin' song. This guy is a screen legend. This guy is considered a true gentleman. And this guy, the ladies will love. Hell, the men that love the men will love him too. A lot of people will appreciate this man. The late, great Cary Grant. Definitely one of the greatest leading men of all time. Phenomenal actor. Born 1904, passed away in 1986 at the age of 82. I remember when he passed away. Yep. So, let's bring out a great blues song. Moaning at Midnight, Howlin' Wolf, 1951. A legendary song indeed, one of my favorite blues songs of all time. And there's so many to choose from. It's one of my favorites. I'm just playing some random great music, folks, as we bring out Cary Grant. Definitely a worthy choice for Hunk of the Day. I've been wanting to feature him for a long time. You know what they say? Drink up, you son of a bitch.
Somebody knocking on my door.
Dave Bauer, Tom Barkley, let me tell you something. I gotta brew my own beer. This is freaking insanely awesome. Chester Allen Burnett, or Chester Arthur Burnett, the real name of the late great Howlin' Wolf. Born June 10th, 1910, passed away January 10th, 1976, the age of 65. This guy, 6'4", 260 pounds of pure, unadulterated badass. Cary Grant, he was just a badass, period. And he aged very gracefully, very well. Even as an older man, he kept his, quote-unquote, as the ladies would say, good looks. See, I think all men are ugly, disgusting, and repulsive myself. Gross, hairy, balls, gross. Ugh. But if women didn't love men, I wouldn't have my love goddess. And without my love goddess, I wouldn't have my little princess. There's an early picture of Cary Grant, huh? With that butt chin, the ass chin. He always had that ass chin and that look. The ladies loved it, folks. Probably one of the most handsome actors of all time. You gotta give him that. Not a bad looking fella at all. Even as an older age, look at that. Huh? Nice dignified gray hair. Still had his full head of hair. Hey, you like a man in uniform? Yeah. Go Navy. Anchors away. Look at that. This is from 1934, folks. Color photo, 1934 right there. Impressive. He was only 30 years old in that picture. Wow. Late, great Cary Grant. Definitely a screen legend. Phenomenal actor. No doubt about it. Setting up for Babe of the Day number 599. As we mention some more birthdays real quick. How about John Smith? You ever heard of John Smith? Almost everybody probably knows of John Smith. Well, this John Smith is the one that discovered, made that first permanent American settlement. Well, first permanent settlement, that's right, Jamestown, Virginia, baby, 1607. John Smith, born this day in 1580, passed away in 1631 at the age of 51. Back in those days, people didn't live very long, unfortunately. How about Xavier Cugat? Xavier Cugat, very famous band leader, born on this day, January 1st, in the year of our Lord, 1900. How about that? That's kind of cool. Lived to be 90 years old, passed away in 1990. Grandmaster Flash, this will make you feel old. Grandmaster Flash, folks, was born on this day in 1958. Grandmaster Flash is 55 years old. Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five, that's right. Eddie Lacy, phenomenal running back for the Green Bay Packers. Former Alabama Crimson Tide running back. Eddie Lacy, getting it done. Eddie Lacy, 23 years old today. Got a great career ahead of him. J.D. Salinger, phenomenal author, reclusive author. This dude loved his privacy and didn't want to be bothered by anybody. Born on this day in 1919, passed away in 2010 at the age of 91. Wrote that famous book in 1945 that finally was published in 1951, The Catcher in the Rye. Oh, yeah, a book that told it like it was. No doubt about that. I've read that book. Great book. Hank Greenberg, legendary Detroit Tiger. Born on this day in 1911, passed away in 1986 at the age of 75. Glenn Big Baby Davis, 28 years old today. Former badass power forward for the Boston Celtics. We loved Big Baby big time. He was great. Ellen Nordegren. However it's pronounced, she's 34, and she used to be married to one Tiger Woods. Yep, she played with Tiger's Wood. Ha ha ha. Yeah, and then he cheated on her. I don't know what he was thinking. She was hot. Still is hot. Dude, Tiger, what were you thinking, man? Rocky Graziano. Boxer. No, not Rocky Marciano. Rocky Graziano. He was a real boxer. Rocky Graziano. Born this day in 1919. Passed away in 1990. Definitely a legendary Hall of Fame boxer all the way. J. Edgar Hoover. FBI head from 1924 until he died in 1972 at the age of 77. He was born this day in 1895. J. Edgar Hoover. J. Edgar Hoover. More famous of a Hoover than President Herbert Clark Hoover, the 31st President of the United States of America. Listen to this one, folks. On this day in 2000, she's 14 years old today. Carla Sosefina Kovaka, K-A-U-V-A-K-A. She's the first baby born in the year 2000 in the world from the island of Tonga. That's right. Tonga has the most far ahead time zone in the world. And she was the first one born in the year 2000. She's 14. Way to go. Frank Langella, famous for playing Frost Nixon. But I remember him in the 1979 vampire movie. Now, he won in Salem's Lot. But Frank Langella, actor, 75 years old today, according to one source, or 76 rather. I always thought he was born in 1940. I've seen sources that say 1939. I've seen some that say 1938. Make up your mind. How old are you? Either way, Frank Langella is still with us, still going strong. Barry Goldwater, former five-time senator. Barry Goldwater, 1964 U.S. president candidate, Republican side. Barry Goldwater, born this day, 1909, passed away at the age of 89 in 1998. Ty Brown, yeehaw, country singer, up and coming. He's 35 years old today. And then we got Abby McGrew. She's a hottie. Milestone birthday, 30 years old today. She's the wife of that douchebag cocksucker Eli Manning. That lucky bastard. He's got a hottie for a wife, though. Yeah, it happens, you know? It happens. So, all you gotta do is be rich and you can get a hottie. Or you can be lucky like me and get a hottie, too. And I'll take that a lot more than these other women. And I'll drink to that. Oh, sadly, this beer is empty. It's the brain cells of an average Eli Manning fan. Average Eli Manning fan. Folks, it is hard to top. You cannot top what I just drank. But I tell you what, I'm excited. I searched long and hard for 3 hours tonight. I finally found an Albertsons grocery store that had the last 2 6-packs of Harpoon Winter Warmer, baby. It's back. The pride of Boston, Massachusetts, and Windsor, Vermont. 5.9% of absolute exquisite, wicked awesomeness. Folks, this is like my favorite beer of them all, okay? Harpoon Winter Warmer. You remember last year, I drank a ton of them on my show. Excuse me. Brewed with cinnamon and nutmeg, and this stuff is amazing. Proper beer opening apparatus, proper technique. Here we go. I think I bought the last 2 6-packs in Texas. Oh, what a great pop. 45 degree angle right in the beer consumption apparatus right over the keyboard because I'm just that damn good. Still haven't spilled dropped yet. Never have, never will. Oh, these hurt. It's crushing down my ear. It hurts. I won't be wearing these often. Cheers and beers to all you pros, they say in Germany. Goodbye, as they say in Japan. As good as I remember it last year. Folks, A plus all the way. I love it. I love it. I love it. All right. Let's get to our next babe of the day. Babe of the day number 599 on Baron Song of the Day. Scarlett Palmers, P-O-M-E-R-S. Here we go. My man, Big McLeod, who's my male admin, he loves his redheads. I don't know why. But, hey, everybody has their own flavor. And I love all women. All right. Here we go. How about some wild rock and roll rockabilly? Who Slapped John? Gene Vincent, 1956. As we show off Scarlett Palmers. That's an interesting picture of her. Oh, hello. Well, slap the shit out of me. Hello. He loves his redheads. And a lot of you out there. A lot of all y'all love them redheads. Boy, she is hot there, ain't she? I love that picture. A good looking woman man right there. Oh, hey. Now see, it's funny. She looks so good there. I don't think she looks as good there. But that's my personal opinion. Pointed chin. And then she'll turn around and look so freaking hot there. It's kind of like Drew Barrymore. She looked great in one picture and not so great in the other. And then she looks so sweet and innocent there. Well, let's put it this way. The love doctor would take her and hug her and kiss her and squeeze her and all that. If I was single, of course. Scarlett Palmers. Dang. Hello. Bring out the wild one in me, will ya? She's so white. So albino. My camera will not focus on her face on that picture. Weird. Hey, on this day in 2002, the euro becomes the official currency for most of Europe. Ah, yes, the euro, 12 years old today. On this day in 1996, after 27 years, Betty Rubble finally debuts as a Flintstone vitamin. Yeah, I remember as a little kid, I was always wondering why they had Wilma, Fred, Barney, but they didn't have Betty. I thought that was weird. Wasn't fair. Took 27 years, but better late than never, I guess. Hey, they had Dino and they had the Flintstones car, though. That was kind of cool. August Day in 1995, a sad day in the comic world. The last Far Side cartoon, Gary Larson's cartoon, which had started in 1980. The last Far Side cartoon was in newspapers. I don't know why he ended it, but he did. Damn you, Gary Larson. August Day in 1995, the North Atlantic Free Trade Agreement goes into effect. Ah, NAFTA. How about that? God, it seems like yesterday. That's 20 years ago today. Holy smokerooskies. And holy smokes, that's the end of her. On his day in 1990, David Dinkins is sworn in as the first black mayor of New York City. Hard to believe, but it's true. It took all the way till 1990 to have a black mayor in New York City. Crazy. On this day in 1985, I can't believe it. I thought it was a little early, but I guess not. VH1 makes its broadcasting debut January 1st in the year of our Lord, 1985. Wow, I'm getting all kinds of messages on the old Facebook. Holy smokes. Hey, it's what happens when you get 3,000 friends. On this day in 1985, 30 years ago today, Brunei becomes independent of the United Kingdom. Congratulations. Happy Independence Day, Brunei. On this day in 1977, the first woman formally ordained as an Episcopal priest, Jacqueline Means. She means business. Oh, look at this. Not a good day for cigarette folks. On this day in 1971, cigarette advertisements are banned on television. It's been 43 years since cigarette ads were on TV. Unbelievable. Wow. Let's bring out a cigarette smoker and a legend for Honk of the Day number 500, folks. I cannot express the awesomeness of this man. When you think America, you think of this guy. When you think Hunk, you think of this guy. When you think absolute frigging badass, yeah, you think of this guy. Yeah, that's right. And for somebody like him, we're going to play a great gospel song from 1955. Didn't it rain, children? Because I'll tell you what, good God himself loves a man like this. Honk of the Day number 500. Is it you, John Wayne? Is it me? John Wayne, baby! Marion Morrison! That's right, the Duke himself. The legend. I mean, hell, it is. It wouldn't normally be Yeehaw Western Wednesday. So I gotta put a little bit of country into this. And I think John Wayne represents America. I think John Wayne represents legends. This is a guy you didn't mess with. That's right, the Green Berets, 1968. John Wayne, badass mofo. And look at this. From 1930, The Big Trail is first starring feature. He was known as Duke Morrison then. Marion Morrison, 23 years old at the time. And I've watched The Big Trail before. Not a bad movie at all, I might add. John Wayne, 23 years old. Look at that. Wow. That's how most people know him right there. That look of, I'm going to screw you up. I'm going to rip your balls out and beat you with them. That's the same John Wayne right there, folks. 1930. How about that? Amazing. Hunk of the Day number 500. A big milestone for our Hunk of the Day album. So you got to bring it with something huge. Somebody that you will never forget, and nobody has ever forgotten, the late, great John Wayne. Some great folk group harmony right here. Wow. A handsome young man indeed. As he turned into a grizzled veteran. That's how most people know him, you know? The grizzled veteran that would definitely kick your ass. No doubt about it. The late, great John Wayne. What a legend indeed. Hey, on this day in 1969, Jack Kent Cook, owner of the National Hockey League's Los Angeles Kings. You'll love this, folks. Any sports fan will love this. He fines each of his players $100. Why? For not arguing with the referee. Yeah. Isn't that crazy? Jack Kent Cook was like, oh, I am punishing you for not arguing with the referee. Must have been a real bullshit call right there, y'all. On day 1968, hey, the Netherlands gets color TV, so they could see beautiful color like that. On day 1966, all U.S. cigarette packs have to carry the caution: cigarette smoking may be hazardous to your health. Well, you know something? This is obviously from prior to January 1st, 1966, because if you look here, you've got a cigarette ad with John Wayne. And folks, what's that say right there? It says this: the roles I play in movies are far from easy on my voice. I can't risk throat irritation, so I smoke Camels. They're mild. Ha! Interesting. He did die from cancer at the age of 72 in 1979. And ironically, he chose not to do chemotherapy, and he just suffered on until he died. Because he was tough as nails and said, screw it, you know what? I'm going to die. Hell with it. I'm going down, baby. Screw chemotherapy, painkillers and all that. I'm just going to die naturally. Well, you know what? He's probably in a better place nowadays anyway. So, hey, remember this. You only live once. The key to life is to enjoy it. There he's enjoying a little bit of whiskey. That's right. I'm not a big fan of whiskey myself. It's all right. America! That's the John Wayne we know and love right there, folks. There you go. A true hero, legend, badass. The late, great John Wayne. Hunk of the Day number 500. Gotta love it. America! All right. So with that, let's drink up. These things really suck. I'm just going to let you know that right now, y'all. So hell with it. We're going to cover two different years on the same show. As we bring out Captain Morgan's Private Stock, our first shot of 2014. We had our last shot of 2013. Folks, you're witnessing history. It's the first time I've ever taken shots in two different years on the same show. I'm a beer guy, but when it comes to hard stuff, that's my personal favorite. Captain Morgan's Private Stock. Hey, cheers and captain to all y'all. Prost is saying Germany, goodbye as they say in Japan. This might help me wake up too. Wow, yippers. Alright, suck it down with some good old Harpoon Winter Warmer. Tell you what, winter just got warmer in the Love Doctor's caucus. Alright folks, on this day in 1962, Western Samoa gains independence from New Zealand. Happy Independence Day, Western Samoa. On this day in 1956, Sudan declares independence from Egypt and the United Kingdom. On this day in 1955, 60 years ago today, the Rose Bowl and Cotton Bowl are the first sports color cast. That's right, they were broadcast in color. Pretty rare back in those days. Color TV, January 1st, 1955. On this day, 1949, KPRC-TV Channel 2, Houston Yeehaw, Texas NBC affiliate begins broadcasting. On this day, 1949, KTTV-TV Channel 11, Los Angeles, California begins. On this day, 1948, the first color newsreel filmed in Pasadena, California. On this day, 1947, WTTG-TV Channel 5, Washington, D.C. begins broadcasting. Very early TV station. On this day, 1946, ENIAC, that's right, the United States' first computer ever, finished by Marchley and Eckert. On this day, 1944, the first feature-length foreign movie, African Journey, shown on television. Wow! 70 years ago today, New York City. On this day, 1935, the first Sugar Bowl and the first Orange Bowl. How about that? On this day, 1935, 80 years ago today, Alcatraz officially becomes a federal prison. On this day, 1929, Wrong Way Roy Regals. Yep, very famous. He was known as Wrong Way Regals. He ran 60 yards the wrong way with the Rose Bowl fumble recovery. You've seen it on newsreels. I've seen it many times. Oh, God, I'm getting tired. Yep, Roy Regals. I remember when he passed away at the age of 84. But yeah, on this day in 1928, the first United States air-conditioned office building opens. Where at? San Antonio, Yeehaw, Texas. Good place for it. Oh, all right, folks. My man, Big McLeod Hughes, Justin Dimmitt. He loves his redheads. I told him, and I told our lovely lady admin Gidget to pick the hunk of the day. I know she was busy, unable to respond. Very sad about that. But Gidget, we still love you. And I know I haven't heard from you in a while. So Gidget, drop us a line. Let me know if you're still interested in being our lovely, gorgeous, wicked, awesome lady admin. She's been busy lately. It's all good. But our male admin, Big Man Large Huge, he wanted a feature for Babe of the Day number 600. The lovely, gorgeous, wicked, awesome, redhead, Amy Adams. Oh, look at a cleavage. Yeah, French for cleavage. Amy Adams, that's right. She's played Lois Lane. And folks, I think I need to hook my man Big McLeod Huge up with my personal favorite musician of all time. This song was recorded December 29th and 30th, 1957. Became an American icon song. And this man is one of the seven original members of the 1986 Rock and Roll Hall of Fame class, Cleveland, Ohio. This man is 87 years old. He's still doing the duck walk. He's still rocking and rolling, still playing live often. This guy is a badass all the way. Charles Edward Anderson Berry, born October 18, 1926, 87 years old. This guy's in incredible shape. still going strong. Chuck Berry, my man, all-time favorite ever. Johnny B. Good, his most famous song of them all. Folks, it doesn't get any better than this. America! Johnny B. Good, as we bring out the lovely, gorgeous, wicked awesome Amy Adams, Baby of the Day, number 600 on Beer and Song of the Day. Iggy! Hello! She is finer than a new set of snow tires, ain't she? She's got that look of, yep, I'm a freak. And you know what? The Love Doctor is all right with that. Yo! Johnny B. Good! Hey, why not, right? Why not? The Duck Walk on the Duck Dynasty stuff. Love this song, and you should too, and you should love this woe man as well. She is hot, real hot, damn hot. As soon as this show is over, folks, I'm going to drop like a bad habit, okay? And I got two shows to upload because I didn't even get a chance to upload two for Tuesday yet. So, woo, yeah, Amy Adams, Baby of the Day number 600. Folks, Honest Day 1925, Norway's capital, Christiania, changes the name to Oslo. Now you know. On this day, 1923, the Union of Soviet Socialist Republics is established. Boo, hiss. Down with communism. 100 years ago today, in 1914, the first scheduled airline flight from St. Petersburg to Tampa. Tony Janus as the pilot. How about that? On its day, 1913. Hello. Post office begins parcel post deliveries. As previously mentioned, thanks to our trivia question, on this day, 1908, the first time ball signifying the new year is dropped at Times Square. Excuse me. On its day, 1907. President Theodore Roosevelt shakes a record 8,513 hands in one day. The Love Doctor could come close to that. I'm sure y'all be agreeing with that. I'm a handshaking some gun. Oh, look at that. Superman, Lois Lane, eh? On this day in 1906, Dutch law makes driver's licenses mandatory. Interesting. Oh, Supergirl. There you go. Honestly, in 1902, the first Rose Bowl game in Pasadena, California, as the University of Michigan beats the shit out of Stanford 49-0. Wow. I'd say 1901. Happy Independence Day, Australia, because the Commonwealth of Australia is established. Honestly, in 1896, Wilhelm Röntgen announces his discovery of X-rays that he discovered in 1895. Wilhelm Röntgen, thanks to him, we have X-rays, something that is still heavily utilized today. Honestly, in 1886, the first Tournament of Roses was held in Pasadena, California. How about that? I say in 1863, big one, folks. The Emancipation Proclamation is issued by President Abraham Lincoln. That's right. Saying that slavery is illegal. Way to go, Abe Lincoln. I am a huge thumbs up supporter of that, because slavery deserves a big fat GFY. You know what I'm talking about, eh? Right? That's what I'm talking about. Hey, let's give some love to old Canada, indeed. Our neighbors to the north also celebrating the new year as we drool over Amy Adams together. Good friends like my buddy Brian Shaven, who I know is celebrating up there. He's getting crunk drunk like the Love Doctor. It's all good. Hey, on this day in 1862, listen to this one. The first ever U.S. income tax. 3% of incomes over $600, 5% of incomes over $10,000. And look at us nowadays, 28%. Yowza. I know Europe's like as high as up to 80% in like Norway and stuff. Oh, look at that. Look at that, will you? Amy Adams. Definitely a worthy lady for Baby of the Day number 600. Just as John Wayne, worthy of Hunk of the Day number 500. Legends indeed. Very great on the eyes. Let's finish off this day in history. On this day in 1858, Canada begins using the decimal currency system. Awesome. On this day in 1853, the first practical fire engine, horse-drawn fire engine, of course, in the United States, enters service. Wow. I don't know what they did prior to then. On this day in 1852, the first United States public bath opens in New York City. Boy, people were some stinky fools prior to then. Yeah, back in those days, people took a bath once a week. Yeah, some countries, they still do. America, you don't take a bath every day. You're stinky. On this day in 1847, Michigan is the first state to abolish capital punishment. Interesting. And yet they have so much violence in Detroit. Who needs capital punishment? Just have people get whacked, right? On this day in 1840, the first recorded bowling match in the United States, the Knickerbocker Alleys, New York City. On this day in 1838, the first official horse race in South Australia, in Adelaide. On this day in 1804, Happy Independence Day, Haiti, because you gained independence from France. On this day in 1801, Ireland and Great Britain, England and Scotland form the United Kingdom. The United Kingdom official January 1st, 1801. On this day, 1797, Albany replaces the New York City as the capital of New York. Yep, New York City used to be the capital of New York. How about that? Albany was on January 1st, 1797. It still is today. I say 1785, the Daily Universal Register, better known nowadays, 3 years later, they were renamed the Times of London, publishes their first issue. On this day in 1776, General George Washington hoists the Continental Union flag. That's right, baby. There you go. On this day in 1772, the first traveler's checks were issued. Where at? London, jolly old England. Traveler's checks, something that is not used nearly as much anymore. On this day in 1739, J.B.C. Bouvet de Lozier discovers Bouvet Island near Antarctica. Oh, look at that, huh? Antarctica, 1739, interesting, near Antarctica. On this day in 1673, very cool here. Regular mail delivery begins between New York and Boston. Way back in 1673, pretty impressive. On this day in 1502, Portuguese navigators discover Rio de Janeiro. Yeah, 612 years later, Potty Town, United States of the World. And finally on this day in 404, the last gladiator competition in Rome, because the Roman Empire ended that year. And it was the last gladiator competition. Very sad, because boy, what brutality it was. Can you imagine growing up in those days? Good God. I'll drink to that. An hour and 5 minutes and 38 seconds right now. Oh, man. Yep. Empty as the brain cells of an average Montreal Canadiens fan, folks. Well, folks, you know what time it is, right? Damn right, Reverend Dr. B. Folks, it's time to make the fetus a head out, so everybody take care of a wicked awesome night and day. Peace, beta journey. Don't do anything I wouldn't do. Don't drink and drive. You might spill a drink, or you might kill yourself, or somebody else. And drinking or driving is dumber than being a Yanks fan. And what's dumber than that is root for douchebag cocksuckers like Eli. Oh, I'm as gay as Tom Brady, yet my whole family still only has the same amount of rings as you alone, Tom Brady. Squeeze me. Manning, or men slapping women, or animal abuse, or racism, or people that welch on bets, or fake friends, or anybody that supports, defends, or is a member of the Westboro Baptist Church. Things like that are just plain stupid. I definitely deserve a big, fat GFY. Folks, I'm out of here. I'll see y'all tomorrow. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Bye. Bye. Wow. I've been up for 20 hours straight after 4 hours of sleep. And you know what's great? I don't have to wake up to an alarm clock today. Hell yeah. Look at me. Happy 2014, everyone. Make it. Méchant Genio. French for wicked awesome.